Welkom bij Wessels Woelige Wereld. Wessel van Diepen is afwezig. Hij is nog steeds zijn band aan het plakken. Je weet, zijn fiets is kapot gegaan, dus hij moet nog steeds band plakken. En hij zit nog niet zo heel lang op band plakken, dus dat duurt nog wel een tijdje. Ik mag erbij zijn om de koffie te halen, maar de vervanger van Wessel is niemand minder dan Jim Kerr. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
It's a little sweaty hand.
That's all right.
I'm nervous for 20 years. I'm meeting you.
I'm still nervous.
Okay. Just tell the audience you are the presenter of the show. It's your show. What are your videos tonight?
The videos we have here, the videos I have been given, are Five, Mariah Carey, Ocean Colour Scene, Madonna, The Ubiquitous. Well, there's many, many. So hope everyone enjoys watching them.
You like coffee?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, okay.
Good coffee. Al ben ik dan de koffie halen, ik ga toch wat vragen stellen. Ik bedoel, zo'n man ontmoet je toch niet elke maand, sterker nog, ook niet elk jaar. A lot of things changed since the very early beginning of the Simple Minds.
For sure.
I heard a kind of demo tape.
Yeah, recently. There's an album came out, a CD called The Early Years, mm-hmm. and essentially it's our demo tapes. Mm-hmm. But we were talking earlier, you can hear our beginnings as a punk band.
A really punk band?
I think we're going to return to it.
Is it?
Well, why not? I mean, what I loved about punk was more the ideal that mm-hmm. anyone, and I still believe this, anyone can take a go at making music. You know, you don't have to be a technical genius. Mm-hmm. I think everyone knows that now, but in those days there was a feeling that you had to be a classical guitar mm-hmm. player or have a musical education, when in fact, in terms of rock and roll, all you need is three chords and some attitude or imagination.
What exactly is art glam rock? What is it?
Well, glam rock was probably the sort of terminology given to a lot of the bands or artists that first influenced us, the most obvious being David Bowie, but at that time also Roxy Music, mm-hmm. To a degree Peter Gabriel. People that were, well, you know, working in a rock, but they weren't just, you know, singing the same cliched mm-hmm. blues kind of lyrics. They were taking, being influenced from books, from movies, from different, you know, in the case of Bowie, Tibetan Buddhism, and putting it all, you know, together against a rock backdrop.
Right. Gaat nu aan de meester zelf vragen. What do you think about Hanson? I know, you're thinking they have to visit the barber. Okay, I know.
No, I didn't think that. I've only seen, you know, the singles and such. I mean, those sort of family bands, you know, I always think about the parents. Mm-hmm. I always think, what goes on in the background there? I don't know. I mean, certainly, I've got my brothers, and we have a lot in common, but mm-hmm. I'm trying to imagine what the band would be like.
Simple Minds, it's kind of a reunion.
Well, Simple Minds is a kind of a gang, I suppose, mm-hmm. and through the years, it's something, well, more like a football team. It's a pool of players, mm-hmm. and whoever's right for the occasion and whoever's getting on well, we come together. But for the moment, or certainly throughout this summer and the festivals we are playing, you could say that it's almost a classic Simple Minds lineup playing again.
But is it not a shame that Michael isn't there?
It is a shame. That's why I say almost. Mm-hmm. But I spoke to him last week, and I think at some point in the future he will return to a collaboration. I don't think he doesn't want it. I mean, we love our life. We've loved the touring. We've loved the whole thing, but it's not for everyone. And in the case of Michael, among other things, he did it for 10 years and it doesn't suit him anymore. So that's that.
Dit kunnen we gelijk meenemen voor de Factory Facts. Michael McNeil die gaat dus wel mee toeren. Verwacht Jim zelf. Gaan we kijken naar video's. Zometeen praten we verder over War Babies en uiteraard het nieuwe album van The Simple Minds. Ocean Color Scene in Wissels West. Ocean Color Scene in Wessels woelige wereld en It's a Beautiful Thing. Dan nu tijd voor de prijsvraag. Waarmee te winnen is een pizza slice, een US Marshall t-shirt, een US Marshall cap en ook nog een US Marshall toegangsbewijs voor deze film. Hij gaat vanaf 14 mei in de bioscoop draaien en we hebben zo meteen een fragment voor je. Overigens moet ik even bijvertellen dat, even uit mijn hoofd als voice-over. Het is namelijk zo dat het verhaal, ik kan dingen maar 2 minuten onthouden, dus ik heb het even opgeschreven. US Marshal Sam Gerard, gespeeld door Tommy Lee Jones, en zijn ervaren team opent de jacht op een mysterieuze ex-geheimagent Mark Sheridan. Die wordt vertolkt door Wesley Snipes. Die ontsnapt is nadat het vliegtuig waarin hij met andere gevangenen overgeplaatst werd, neerstortte. Nou, echt super verhaal, ik heb het voorstukje al gezien, maar ik wil het jullie uiteraard niet onthouden. Dus we gaan even kijken naar het fragment.
Sheridan! Sheridan, turn around! Get out from there and face me!
You're gonna have to shoot me!
Turn around!
Can't be caught!
Deze film is dus van de makers van The Fugitive. En leuk is om te weten dat Tommy Lee Jones daarin een bijrol speelde. Dan nu de prijsvraag. Wie speelde in die film de hoofdrol? Dus wie speelde erin de hoofdrol? Je kunt het volgende winnen. Ik heb het net al verteld. Een cap, een US Marshall t-shirt, vrijkaarten en een New York pizza slice. Dus een US Marshall slice van New York pizza. Goed, als je het weet mag jij schrijven met TMF Wessels Woelige Wereld. Postbusnummer komt nu in beeld. Heb je dat? Prima. Dan gaan we nu kijken naar Niet Lachen. Bram van 3000.
Hi, my name is Stereo Mike.
Black Crowes and Jealous Again. You like a lot of music like Black Crowes?
I do like Black Crowes. We played some concerts in America 2 years ago. And they were also playing. Mm. And they were very impressive as a band, mm-hmm. and albeit they're working from a real sort of traditional line, but and as guys, they were exceptionally good guys, yeah.
What kind of person is Jim Kerr? Is he always thinking about the news and things which happen in the world and writing about,
here's today's news. Here's the news. No, I think I'm a mixture, you know, a contrast. I mean, we're very serious about, we take our music very serious. I don't know if we take ourselves that serious, but it's one regret I do have, that certainly when we played on stage through the years, our humor was never represented there. It just didn't seem to be room for it. Whereas anyone around us, I think, would, you know, testify that that's not, but not really the way where we are. But it's, I'm like most, you know, people. I'm very, very fortunate in as much I have this great job that I do, and it's our art and our passion. But at the weekend, like anyone else, I'll be with friends, tomorrow the football, maybe the cinema at night. You know, very average, I think.
You're crazy about football?
I am, yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. I'm in the home of it here. Uh-huh. Not, yeah.
Some people say that you guys have to go back in the middle of a tour to go back to Scotland for joining the teams.
Well, if we can, we do. I mean, actually, last week I was in the airport in Bologna, and I had to hear the last 20 minutes of a game by radio, so I had to call my mother and get her to put the phone to the radio. But it's like, you know, we grew up with, and we were fortunate. We had a great team then, and I grew up in a generation that I also saw the great Ajax team and such, and when they came to Glasgow, and they're big, just like music. These guys, big heroes and influences in some ways.
Je hoorde het zelf, Jim Kerr van de Simple Minds kent zelfs Ajax en hij is een fan van. Nou, dat mogen we onthouden. Ga kijken naar een video, blijf kijken naar TMF, Wessels woelige wereld. So rhymes to turn it up, fired it up. Dat is een alarmschijf vorige week bij Radio 58. En misschien leuk om te weten, we gaan daar even over praten. You like hip-hop music? And
I gotta say, it's not my, you know, culture. It's not something that I'm turned on to it. Probably because I still love singing.
What about Britpop then?
Well, I do. I think there's been a lot of... I mean, the terminology gets... It all gets a bit... It outgrows that. But I think the last few years, there's been... the bands that have had big success, I can understand why, whether it's Verve or Radiohead or Blur Oasis. Mm-hmm. They've made the quality music.
But you don't think it's a Beatle rip-off?
Yeah.
Okay, clear. Clear. Okay. You're still angry with Liam Gallagher?
For what?
For marrying your ex-wife?
No, not at all. My ex-wife is the mother of my child, and I want her to be happy. Mm-hmm. And, you know, if she's happy, the kid's happy, so I'm happy.
The kids are not happy. He's always singing Wonderwall every day. Okay. You will be back in Holland for Hunten Pop. I've heard it's a little place in Holland for a big gig, you guys, 27th of June. What can we expect there?
Well, hopefully, Simple Minds are known as, I think, a great live band. And I think a great show from us would show the past, the present, and maybe even a clue as to the next step as well. So that's what we'll be trying to achieve.
What will be the next step because of War Babies? Is it a new sound of the Simple Minds?
I think you always want to feel that you're creating new ground, but essentially, the ideal is probably the same from day one. We want to make strong, emotional music. Mm-hmm. And whether it's with a rock or whether it's with some electronic, whether it's a Celtic melody, it doesn't really matter. I mean, they all interest us. So we'll see. But I think the current album, Neapolis, I can feel a door opening with this, and I think there's an avenue still there with a lot of room to explore.
Billy Myers and Kiss the Rain. You ever kissed the rain?
I've tasted it.
But you didn't like it. Let's talk about your and of course Simple Minds new album. A lot of things. Earlier in the interview, I talked about it, has changed.
Yeah.
But what is the most important message in this album?
I would think the message is, well, we would like the most, you could say, the most important effect, as opposed to message. I mean, we don't have any answers, you know. Sometimes the music, if it works well, can make you think or maybe make you ask some questions. But I think what's important that it comes across that we love what we do and we love doing it. Mm-hmm. And if that comes across fundamentally, then I think that's a good thing. Anything else, then that's also a bonus.
I wrote the inlay, the CD, but I didn't see lyrics. Why not?
It's, you know what it is? It's I feel, you know, the words are designed to sit inside the music. I mean, I know a lot of people want to sing along, so they want to know what it is, but they're not poetry, and they're not, you know, stories, and they're not, you know, literature as such. They're picked to sing well. And I felt, I understand now, maybe it was a mistake, but I felt to, sometimes when you take them out and put them blank, you know, they seem more important than they were intended, or they seem a little bit clumsy or naked or whatever. But for those that really want to know them, you can find them on the website, simpleminds.com. Plug. So they're not, we're not hiding them. And also on the CD booklet, you know, when you get all those words, there's no, as a piece of art, it all seems so crammed and, you know, so much information. But yeah, they can be found.
Okay. The album version, War Babies, is different than the single one.
Yeah.
Why is it? It's a remix.
It's a remix. I mean, I guess this is something, when we do the album, we do it as we want it. When it comes to singles, they're essentially promotional tools. Right. And that's where the record companies and people that have to deal with you people, you know, they think, well, this will work better and such. Sometimes they're right, sometimes not. But I think it's almost like a more focused mix is what you're trying to get. But yeah, I think there's pros and cons.
You're a little bit running out of time. Thanks for dropping by. I have a million
pleasure.
Questions to ask you.
A
but
pleasure.
Okay.
All right. Thanks. All the best.
By. Jim Kerr.
Nu Laila. En alsof je bij me bent in Wessels woelige wereld. Goed, Jim Kerr is vertrokken. Heel jammer, ik had nog zoveel vragen aan deze man. Maar hij moest weer door, hij moest een vliegtuig halen. Dus we hebben afscheid van hem genomen net. Goed, voor degene die trouwens net Wessels woelige wereld ofwel TMF aanzet. Die heb iets waanzinnigs gemist, want we hadden Jim Kerr hier in de studio. En die zie je toch niet elke dag, niet waar? Dan gaan we nu kijken naar, hoe heet die vage gast ook weer met zijn bijdrage? In ieder geval de bevrijdingsdag.
TMF Extra.